But as in gigabytes, honor is quite a trade. The company system knows it's past the best buy date. It's too small for a mail server, but we have to go live. We hope that there will not be much mail to fill the drive. The server went alive that day, but didn't last for long. In a few hours all mail it was, because something went wrong. No space left on the mail pool, it's grand, no we know why then. As we counted the requirements, we forgot about spam. The spam port in torrents, it was a sight to see. Mortgages some cheap Viagras and get a loan for free. Doesn't reach their generals in some advanced vision. It seems people still can fall for a Nigerian scam. We tried some IP blacklisting, it didn't do much good. It improved just a little, but not as much as it should. So we enabled graylisting, the traffic dropped a bit. The difference was way too small to get us out of it. We deployed Spam Assassin, it was easy like a breeze. But Perl was too slow and took the machine to its knees. We turned to bias filters, the trials we described to throttle down the influx of mail that fills the drive. The spammers don't give up with ease, they are a stubborn lot. They switch to using zombies from off machines with a bot. With force harvesting addresses, it's difficult to fight. We are pushed into the corner by the advertising blight. The spams are changing every day to get through our defense. To pass through bias filters, there's a text that makes no sense. Misspellings foil the keyword scans and there's a thick most while. Send in a graphic attachment, text as a picture file. So now we are back online, we couldn't take the risk that we'll run out of space again, we bought a bigger disk. Sometimes there's only one way to make the server thrive. Go out and buy a Nordic space for mail that fills the drive.